Babies born with a cleft palate often have a conductive hearing loss due to the opening in the palate. Your baby will be seen regularly by an audiologist to monitor their hearing. Audiologists are healthcare professionals who specialize in hearing and balance difficulties. In this video, you will hear about audiology and what to expect with your child's ears and their hearing when they have a cleft palate. First, let's go over some ear anatomy. There are three main parts to the ear: the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. The outside of your ear, also called the pinna, captures sounds and funnels them down the ear canal all the way to the eardrum, or tympanic membrane. Your middle ear is made up of several parts. The first part is your eardrum. Sound captured by the pinna and funneled down the ear canal causes the eardrum to vibrate. This vibration causes the three tiny bones behind the eardrum to move. Another part of the middle ear is the eustachian tube. This tube connects the middle ear to the upper throat and the back of the nose. It helps to equalize the pressure in the middle ear. Mucus or congestion from the mouth and nose can travel through the eustachian tube and sit in the middle ear behind the eardrum. This may cause some hearing difficulties, which we will discuss in a moment. The final part of the ear, the cochlea, or organ of hearing, is designed like a rolled-up piano. The third bone in the middle ear, the stapes, vibrates into the cochlea. There are little hair cells inside the cochlea which function like piano keys and move when stimulated by different sounds. When a hair cell moves, an electrical signal is sent to the auditory nerve, which carries it up to the brain, and that is how we hear sound. Babies born with a cleft palate are at risk for developing what is called a conductive hearing loss. This type of hearing loss happens when there is a problem in either the outer ear or the middle ear. Sometimes it can be both. Because there is an opening in the palate, mucus or congestion is able to travel easily between the mouth, nose, throat, and ears. With mucus or congestion in the middle ear, sound cannot reach the cochlea as well as it normally does. This results in what is called a conductive hearing loss. A conductive hearing loss caused by congestion will generally range from mild to moderate in degree. Everyday speech may sound a little bit muffled. Many children with a cleft palate and evidence of a conductive hearing loss will have a ventilation tube inserted into their eardrum. The tube is tiny and usually falls out on its own in 6 to 12 months. The hole in the eardrum will naturally heal and close on its own. A doctor that specializes in ear, nose, and throat problems, called an otolaryngologist or ENT, will assess if a tube needs to be inserted into your child's eardrum. If a tube is needed, the procedure is usually done at the same time as the palate repair. Your cleft lip and palate, or CLP team, will coordinate these appointments. The first ENT visit is usually scheduled when your child is about 9 months of age. Once the tube is inserted, it will help drain out the fluid that has collected in the middle ear. ENT and audiology will monitor the status of your child's hearing after the tubes have been inserted. In most cases, hearing returns to normal. All newborn babies can have their hearing screened by Ontario's Infant Hearing Program, or IHP. IHP locations are designated by the family's home address. Hearing screening should be done at the location closest to your home. Your local IHP location will work with your CLP program to coordinate audiology care. An IHP screener or nurse will run a quick and automatic test in each ear that will provide the result of either pass or refer. If your child receives a refer result, they will be sent for a diagnostic hearing test through their local IHP. If your child receives a refer result in one or both of their ears, then additional testing will be needed. Your child may be scheduled for a diagnostic auditory brainstem response test, or what we call an ABR. This test measures the brain's response to sound and checks the health of the entire auditory pathway to determine whether or not there is a permanent hearing loss. This would be scheduled for the next available appointment at your local IHP location. Your child will continue to have regular audiology follow-up appointments. Follow-up is to monitor your child's hearing and to make sure that they continue to have good access to sounds from both ears as they continue to develop. If your child had tubes inserted, then the audiology appointments will be scheduled at the same time as the ENT appointments. If no tubes were needed, then the audiology appointments will be scheduled on the same day as other appointments for your child. So to summarize, at birth, your child will have a newborn hearing screen at their local IHP location. If they pass, then they will have a follow-up hearing test when they are 9 months old, scheduled by the CLP program. If they receive a refer, then they will have immediate follow-up scheduled by their local IHP location. When your child is 9 months old, they will have a pre-palate repair hearing test scheduled by the CLP program. And then when your child is 15 to 18 months old, they will have a post-palate repair hearing test scheduled by the CLP program in coordination with the local IHP. Follow-up hearing tests for your child will be scheduled by the CLP program at the same time as their ENT appointments. Regular audiology monitoring can often be arranged locally and closer to home to minimize travel to and from the hospital. Thank you for watching this video. We are here to help. If you have any questions or need further tips, please contact your child's audiologist or CLP team. Thank you.